who has a lot of fans right here.
My
wow.
Guys.
Wow.
My favorites.
Lex.
They are my small group.
I got a question for you.
I love them. What's up, Kate?
What are your plans next weekend?
What am I doing next weekend? Frequency!
Yes. Woo! Yes. Raise your hand if you are going to Frequency.
Who's going to Frequency? Good, good.
Okay, raise your hand if you're not going to Frequency.
Who's not going?
I need whoever's around those people raising their hand to look at them and say, why are you going to Frequency?
Dude, right now, why aren't you going to Frequency?
If your answer is you're in sixth grade, you're off the hook.
You gotta sign up. It's very worth it.
All right, we love to play games here in Transit, and today you're all playing a game, okay? This game is called This or That.
Or that.
Everybody say This or That.
This or That.
Right on, yes. Really simple. You're gonna get a question up on the screen, and you're gonna either face that side of the room if you agree with that as your favorite fall thing, or this side of the room if you think that that's the better option, okay? Everything's fall themed because yesterday was the first day of fall. Who's excited that it's fall?
Me. Fall for the win. It's the
best. All right.
Let's play This or That.
See the first question.
Let's see. Ooh, apple cider or hot cocoa? Hot cocoa for me. Apple cider?
Hot cocoa. I need to see some really strong opinions, okay?
Absolutely.
I don't want to see anyone facing the middle of the room. You got to pick a side. Gracely, you got to pick a side, girl.
Let's see our next slide. Ooh, pumpkin pie. Pumpkin pie or apple pie. Pumpkin pie for me.
There's a lot of sweet treats in this mix.
We got a lot of apple pie.
Pumpkin with this one.
I'm a pumpkin too.
I like pumpkin.
We got a lot of apple pie there.
The dollop of whipped cream on there. So good.
It's delicious.
Tastes like fall. Let's see the next one.
Let's see. Ooh, Thanksgiving or Halloween? Halloween sooner. You get to dress
Reagan
up.
Reagan says Halloween.
She says Halloween.
Oh, she changed
Who
her mind.
Who says Thanksgiving?
She changed her mind. She
Anybody?
Likes Thanksgiving.
Anybody?
You get to eat a lot on both of
That's
these.
That's true.
Both of these occasions.
You get to eat pumpkin pie.
So, yeah,
so
I
good.
Do. All right, what's the next one?
Watching football or watching a movie? Movie for us.
Goose is conflicted. You're right down the middle.
It's
she doesn't want to choose. She doesn't want to choose.
Takes up a lot of time.
I like it. I feel like most of the girls are watching a movie.
Pretty good.
Okay, what's that next one?
Bonfire or fireplace? What do we think?
I don't
what
know.
Do you think?
Those fuzzy socks look pretty good.
They are.
I'm going bonfire on this one.
I think so too. Like to be outside. In the
yeah,
crisp weather.
Maybe.
See the fall leaves?
Sure.
It's cozy.
Sure.
Fireplace, it's hot.
It is.
Yeah.
Indoors.
Indoors?
Yeah.
Who wants to be indoors? Nobody.
All right, what's next for fall?
Ooh,
oh, this is controversial.
Candy corn. Very controversial. Like candy corn?
What kind of people are we? We like candy corn?
No.
We hate it?
No, Reagan.
It's good decoration, I feel like. I love candy corn.
I love candy corn.
I love it. I think it's good.
Man, see,
Hot
you're
take.
A winner. You're
Hot
a winner.
Hot take.
Let's see. All right. What's our next one?
Last one, guys.
Last one. S'mores or cinnamon rolls?
One you can have in your fireplace, and the other one you have
rolls.
At the bonfire.
Yes.
Also, these don't feel like the same. I like both of those things.
Man. I think
oh,
I got to
pick
both.
Oh, that's amazing. All the fall things. It's fall. We're excited.
We're so excited.
Today's going to be a little bit different. So we're actually going to hear our message from Caleb first, and then we're going to worship together. So you guys go ahead and
take a seat.
Take a seat. And Caleb will be out here in just a second.
Transit, how we doing? Good? Let's go. Y'all are like awake and ready for this thing. Real quick, who went somewhere on fall break? Who went somewhere? Yeah? A good bit. Who went to the beach? Who went to the beach? I heard you. I heard you. Does anybody go anywhere other than the beach? Did anybody go anywhere else? Where'd you go? D.C.? How was that? Yeah, D.C. is pretty cool. Where else? Where else did we go? Las Vegas. Next question. Where did you go? Great Wolf Lodge. That's awesome. That's awesome. Well, I'm glad you guys are back from fall break. I shouldn't have asked so many questions again. I'll let y'all to her. There we go. There we go. Well, guys, I'm excited. Also, if we haven't met yet, my name's Caleb. Glad you're here. We're about to start a new series called Bless Your Heart, where we are talking all about emotions. And fellas, please stick with me. Please stick with me. It's going to be worth it. I promise. We are going to talk all about emotions, these big emotions in our lives that lead us to act in ways that maybe we do want to act or we don't want to act or we just don't know how we got where we are. We're going to take a look, a closer look at our emotions. But in order to do that, first, I want to set us up with a little story. So about 3 years ago, I started talking to this girl. Her name's Alyssa. She's pretty cute. Whatever. We're still dating. But early on in the relationship, I was trying to impress her like any guy probably wants to do with a girl that they're into, right? And I realized two truths that I hope you guys can confirm are true about women. The first is that they love a man that can cook and they love queso. Yes? Yes? Okay, cool. Okay, we got it right. Thank you. I see you. So I'm like, okay, let me take out this crock pot that I've never used in my entire life and I'm gonna cook some queso. It took me about an hour to make a recipe. Also, side note, I just hate at the bottom of these websites, they're like, it's only gonna take you 25 minutes. And then like an hour, I'm like, I'm not Rachel Ray, okay? I'm not Gordon Ramsay. So anyway, it takes me like an hour to make this queso. I'm chefing, I'm cooking, it takes forever. I bring it to her, we take the chips, we dip, we take a bite, and y'all, it was the worst thing I've ever put in my mouth in my entire life, yo. And I put like sand and boogers in my mouth as a kid, and this still somehow was worse than that. And I'm sitting there, and I'm kind of looking at her out of the corner of my eye to see if she's gonna take another bite, and she's just kind of like, I'm like, oh man, we gotta throw this out. So we threw it out, and I'm like, but next time I got it. Because next time I'm like, I didn't use the white cheese. I feel like you gotta use the white cheese. The yellow cheese isn't, it's just like Velveeta at that point, right? And so we try like 3 or 4 more times, and I still am just, I'm a master at making terrible queso, right? And so we're like, whatever, let's just stick to, I don't know, I think I did like buffalo chicken dip or something like that, which is still pretty fire. But a year later, after I've learned how to cook at this point, I knew how to cook, I just couldn't cook well. I look back at the recipe, and y'all know what happened. So the recipe called for 2 cloves of garlic. I, who barely eats vegetables or fruit in my life, think that 2 cloves of garlic is 2 bulbs. And if you stick with me for a second, because I think the fellas are still probably lost. Guys, garlic comes in this thing called a bulb. It looks like a mini onion. And a clove is like a piece, a little piece off of that. It called for 2 cloves. I put 2 bulbs of garlic into this queso. Y'all, when I tell you, my breath was rank. It was absolutely horrific, right? And the reason I tell you this is because what happened there was I was just looking at the end product. I was looking at the finish line and going like, I didn't want to get here. How did I get here? Now that I'm here, I don't know what to do. We just got to like throw it out, right? We got to get some kind of different food. We've got to like change the game plan. And y'all, the same thing happens with our emotions. Sometimes we're so unaware of our emotions until they're just huge, right? Until it's just like, whoa, how did we get here, right? We don't typically think about our emotions until they're overwhelming. We don't realize, adults in the room, let me know if y'all feel this. We don't realize that we're burning out until we're burnt out, right? We don't realize until we're like exhausted that we were headed on a trajectory to exhaustion. For some of y'all, for a lot of y'all in this room, you don't realize that you're heading towards being so depressed and anxious that you can't get out of bed until you're there. And the same can happen with positive emotions too, right? Like, you ever seen a kid like go to Disneyland for the first time? You ever seen those videos where it's like, oh, or no, y'all wanna talk about overwhelming emotions? I don't do this to cry, I promise, but you ever seen those soldiers coming home videos? We're not going to talk about it. But right, like there's good, bad. Either way, sometimes we don't realize the emotions until they're overwhelming. We don't realize that we should have been saying no to more things before we got burnt out. We don't realize that we needed a little bit more of an injection of joy and happiness and time with people in our lives until we're just depressed and withdrawn. We don't realize that we were missing someone so much until they come back. So instead of looking ahead, instead of waiting for the moment when the emotions get so big that our actions are just kind of happening on their own, how do we pay attention beforehand, right? Instead of looking at the fruit of something, why don't we look at the root, what was planted to get us here? Well, I think there's a passage in the Bible that can help us as we figure this out, and it's in the book of Proverbs. So if you don't know a little bit of context, there's this guy named Solomon. A lot of people in church, outside of church, argue that he was the wisest man to ever live, right? And in this chapter of Proverbs, he's talking to his son, and he's trying to teach him how to live a good life, how to live a life full of wisdom. And this is what he says to his son. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Above all else, greater than anything you could focus on if you're trying to live right, if you're trying to live with wisdom, above all else, guard, protect, pay attention, focus on your heart. Why? Because everything you do flows from it. Every thought, every action, every emotion flows from your heart. And if you're like me and you grew up in church and you've heard like the guard your heart and protect your heart, and you're like, I don't even know what that means. Let me break it down for you a little bit. Here's the progression that I found typically happens with our emotions. Typically it starts, excuse me, with a thought that leads to an attitude, right? So if you think about it, if you've ever gone to a space that you don't necessarily want to be in, and the thought is, I don't want to be here, then the attitude is you being withdrawn, is you being apathetic, or like, I don't know. And so the thought leads to the attitude, then the attitude, y'all know this, leads to the action. If I feel withdrawn, or if I don't want to be there, I'm just going to give a one-sentence answer. If somebody asks me a question, y'all ever been in a conversation with somebody who gives you a one-sentence answer? And you're like, cool, I'm a head out. I read you loud and clear, right? Like, our thoughts will lead to our attitudes, will lead to our actions. Excuse me, I got to stop coughing. And here's what happens most of the time. We are more worried about our behavior than our heart. We are typically more worried about our behavior than our heart. And that makes sense, right? Because all we're kind of taught growing up is management or behavior management, excuse me. Like, I don't know about you guys, but I got spanked a lot growing up because I made some unwise choices. But I don't think you're allowed to do that anymore because it's like offensive to kids. But I got spanked a whole lot growing up. And so what that taught me is, I don't want to feel this pain, I'm not going to do that thing. I don't want to feel this pain, I'm not going to do, I don't want to feel this pain, I'm not going to. And obviously as a 5 or 6 year old, I didn't have the wisdom or maturity to do this, but I never thought, wait a minute, what's the emotion I'm feeling that led me to this? What's the thought that I had that led me to make that choice, to do that thing? I never thought to consider that. And y'all, if you can get this now, I promise it's gonna help you for the rest of your life. I'm not saying this to you just because you're like some middle schoolers and you're immature and you don't know about your emotions. Like, I'm telling you this because you're gonna need this for the rest of your life. And it's this: monitoring your heart is the first step to managing your behavior. If you want the way that you're acting when you feel big emotions, or the way you're responding when you feel big emotions, to be different, the first step to doing that is monitoring your heart. So what do we have to do? We have to pay attention to our hearts. I want you to pay attention to your heart. And again, that's guard your heart, pay attention to your heart. It still feels like kind of unknown, like this big, like, I don't know how to do that. So I'm gonna try to simplify it for us. I'm gonna give us 2 things that we can try in order to pay attention to our hearts. The first thing is this: we need to define our emotions. I want you to define the emotions you're feeling, because here's the truth. The life that you're able to experience will be dependent on the limitations of the way you can define your emotions. So the ability that you have to define your emotions directly impacts the quality of life you experience. Because it's one thing to say like, oh no, like I'm happy or I'm sad or I'm angry. But when you look closer at feeling sad and you look a little bit closer to the root instead of the fruit and you're like, wait a minute, I'm not just sad, like I'm confused. In this class, I don't really know what's going on and I'm trying to understand. I'm studying all the time. I'm doing the worksheets. I'm with a tutor even, and I still am confused. That will help you respond to the situation better. But when you're just sad, like, it's kind of hard to know what to do with that, right? Or in the same way, if you're ever like angry, you're angry at a friend, and you don't just want to walk up to your friend and be like, I'm angry at you, fix that. It's like, I don't know. Right? When you're able to look a little closer and you're like, wait a minute, I feel betrayed. I feel like you did something to me that I didn't deserve. When you're able to define your emotions, you're able to more specifically respond to them. You're able to respond to them with better wisdom. And that kind of leads to the second thing that I want us all to do is to seek wisdom. And that can be hard. That takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of practice. But a great place to start is the book of Proverbs. That book that we just read from with that verse, above all else, guard your heart. Like that is a book literally full of wisdom. And if I can be honest with y'all for a second, there's a time probably, I don't know, 4 or 5 years ago, I grew up in church, my dad was a pastor. I knew all the sayings, I knew what to do in worship, I knew how to respond during the talks, but I never really took it seriously. Like really never took it seriously until I got sat on my butt, right? Like I got into a situation where my emotions were so big, y'all, I couldn't get out of bed. I was struggling to eat. I'll be honest, it was a breakup. It was before Alyssa, don't worry, she's great. But it was a breakup and I was questioning everything about myself, about the world, about God, because these emotions that I had felt so insurmountable, felt so impossible to get over that I was like, all right, God, like, I'm really gonna go after this. I'm gonna give you one shot, dude, because if you're not real, if this is not it, then I'm done. Like, there's no hope. I've got nothing going for me. So I went to the book of Proverbs, y'all. It rocked me. It wrecked me in the best way possible because it was a book of wisdom. It gave me so many things to think about and consider, not just in living a life like Christ would, like not just in trying to be a good Jesus follower, but just in handling life situations better. So, as we pay attention to our hearts and as we try to define our emotions before they get too big to the point where we're just acting without even thinking because like we just have to because it's just overflowing from us, I want us to start by first being able to define our emotions, being able to get a better vocabulary around what we're feeling because it directly impacts the life we have, but also to seek after wisdom because also wisdom, it only comes from God. You can get a lot of knowledge, a lot of understanding, a lot of book smarts or street smarts based on like your own work ethic of just what you experience in life. But wisdom, true wisdom only comes from the Lord, it comes from a relationship with the Lord. So we're gonna do, as I said earlier, we're switching up the service, we're doing worship at the end, and I wanna challenge you guys to do something as we step into worship. I wanna challenge you guys to bring your emotions to God. I think a lot of times we feel like we have to check our emotions at the door. Like we've got to check all of our baggage, like leave it there and then come in here and be happy because that's what our friends need. That's what our small group leader wants. That's what God wants, right? But here's the thing. God can't handle something you don't bring to him. God cannot handle something you don't bring to him. He can handle it all. He can handle, like this dude, God, guy, whatever, made everything. He made you. He knows the emotions you're feeling. He knows what you're walking through. He wants to help. And maybe not in the help that we're thinking of just removing us from those circumstances or those situations or the emotions we feel, but he can step in and help us monitor our heart, manage our behavior in a better way, but he can't do that if you don't go to him. So, as we step into worship, if you're feeling maybe just disappointed from the way that fall break went, maybe you were expecting different conversations and relationships with your family or your friends. Maybe you're feeling fear about stepping into school this next week. You're like, yo, I just got a break and I remembered how much better life is when I don't have to be at school, like all the time. Whatever emotion you're feeling right now, maybe you're feeling great and that's awesome. You're totally allowed to feel great. Maybe you're feeling great. Let's try bringing that to God in worship. And the way you bring it to him is not just like, like you don't just like throw it at him. You can literally, you can have the physical posture of opening your hands. Maybe for the beginning of the first song, maybe you're not singing it. Maybe you're praying. Maybe you're talking to God and you're just like, hey, oh, dude, I'm feeling this way. And like, I don't know what you want me to do about it. I don't know if you want to do something about it, but I'm just going to bring it to you. I'm just talking to you about it. Like, I'm dealing with this thing. I would love your help. Like, whatever that may look like, whatever you think that may look like, to bring your emotions to God in worship, I want you to try that right now because I promise. I promise. When you bring everything you have to God, not just the good, not just the what you feel like he deserves or what you feel like he can handle, when you bring it all to him, something changes. And I've experienced it in my own life. I'm not just telling you because a verse told me that. Like, I've experienced in my own life what that looks like. And I want it for you guys too. But again, it does not happen unless you bring it to him. It does not happen unless you're honest with him. So as we step into worship, let's try that. Bring it all to him. But I'm gonna pray for us first, and then we'll sing together. Lord, thank you for another Sunday morning in transit where we can try to learn just a little bit more about you, learn a little bit more about what it looks like to be a good Christ follower or to handle our emotions well and to even maybe realize that you care about our emotions. That our emotions are neither good or bad, they're just indicators. They just point to how we're feeling, how we're thinking, and you are not afraid of that. You're not afraid of our emotions. You're not mad about us having emotions. You're not mad when we're angry. You're not mad when we're sad or feeling depressed or anxious or fearful. Like, that doesn't upset you. Instead, you want to show us that there's more for us. So God, Holy Spirit, prompt these students to bring it to you, to respond. Prompt these students to step forward and be bold, be courageous and say, Lord, yeah, I need you. I can't do this on my own. I don't know what I'm feeling. I don't know how I'm responding, but I do need help. And Lord, would you provide that help? Would you provide it personally through your spirit? Would you provide it through the small group leaders around these kids, through the other students in their small group? And would this be the beginning of a lifetime of bringing things to you, a beginning of a lifetime of honesty with you, because that will allow us to experience even more and better life. We love you. We pray this in your name. Amen.
All right, Transit, we're gonna sing together. Let's give him your worship this morning. Let's sing this out.
All our words fall short. I've got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song
again, 'cause all that I have is a heart.
Don't you get shy on me, lift up your soul, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. So come on, my soul, don't you get shy on me, lift up your soul, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs.
Speaking, oh, can you see it? He's got your healing. Oh, just receive it. Receive the freedom. Oh, can you feel it? Sing it. Heaven.
If it's not the truth, then what?
Transit. Thank you for singing with us. We love you. You're dismissed to small groups.
We're all so tired of everything.